This problem deals with the analysis of some batch kinetic data for the reaction that involves A plus 2B irreversibly going to products. The initial concentration of B is twice that of A, and a measurement of the concentration of A is made with respect to time. When the reciprocal of that concentration is plotted versus time, then we get this straight line relationship. And based on that, we have these competing claims about what that means in terms of the reaction orders with respect to component A. And that is equal to the rate with which A accumulates, or the negative of the rate with which it's consumed. So that's the rate constant times the concentration of A to some power alpha that we're going to try to evaluate, and the concentration of B to some power beta. The trick in this problem, if you can call it that, is that the concentration of B initially is equal to double the concentration of A. And in fact, at all times in the reactor, it's going to be double, because this is a stoichiometric reaction, and so every time we consume a mole of A, we'll consume 2 moles of B, so that we can write this relationship as being generally true. All right, and so because of that, then we can actually replace the concentration of B with 2 times the concentration of A. We then can collect terms in that expression, and I'll write that down here, that now our differential equation reads that dCA dt is equal to negative k times 2 raised to the beta power times the concentration of A raised to the alpha plus beta power. And so we see that we have this alpha plus beta term. You can analyze this a few different ways, but anticipating what the answer is, we're going to assume that alpha plus beta is equal to 2. And so this represents a way of doing the integral analysis of batch kinetic data, where we're going to pick a reaction order and then see if we were correct, basically, in terms of the experimental data that we observe. Okay, so if alpha plus beta is equal to 2, then we can separate out these two sides of the differential equation. And on this side, we get dCA over CA squared. And on the other side, we'll get a negative k times 2 to the beta again, right, times time, because we'll have the dt over there, but these two terms do not depend on time, they're just constants with time, and also constants with respect to concentration, right, and so we just get an integral of dt, which gives us time. All right, on this side, we're going to evaluate from CA naught to CA, and if we do that evaluation, then we'll simply get a 1 over CA minus 1 over CA naught. Okay, and so we see that if we plot the concentration of A, or the reciprocal of the concentration of A, versus time, then we should get a straight line relationship where this would be the slope and our intercept would be determined by the reciprocal initial concentration. Okay, but this doesn't mean that we have an order with respect to A of 2. All right, all it means is that we have our total order is 2. And we actually can't tell whether the order in A is 1 or 2 or 0 or some other number. All right, and so we actually have to do another experiment where the starting material is not in the stoichiometric concentration ratio, for example, with one of the components in great excess, in order to determine what the reaction order is with respect to the individual components. All right, here we can only determine what the total reaction order is.